নাই
হবে বাসায়, কিন্তু তোমার লাইফ হবে না, তো গেছিলাম দেখ।
থিঙ্ক সো উই ক্যান স্টার্ট দ্য সেশন।
ওকে, সো শ্যাল আই স্টার্ট নাও প্রীতা বা? শ্যাল আই স্টার্ট নাও প্রীতা ম্যাম?
ইয়েস ইয়েস ইয়েস।
গুড মর্নিং এভরিওয়ান, রেসপেক্টেড স্পিকার, চেয়ারপারসন, ডেপুটি চেয়ারপারসন এন্ড পার্টিসিপেন্টস, আই শিল্পী গুপ্তা, কনভিনার অফ দ্য ন্যাশনাল ওয়ার্কশপ অন ইন্টেলেকচুয়াল প্রপার্টি রাইট অর্গানাইজড বাই ডক্টর আর কে বি ল কলেজ, আইকিউএসসি অফ ডক্টর আর কে বি ল কলেজ এন্ড কোকরাঝাড় ল কলেজ, welcome you all to this third day of the workshop. Now I will take the privilege to introduce our dynamic speaker, Dr. M.V. Bhimesh sir, of today's technical session. Dr. M.N. Bhimesh has completed LLM in international law and PhD in media law from Mysore. He, as a senior advisor to ALMT Legal, was involved in practice with special emphasis on patent, trademark, copyright, design and GI. He was also a former reader and chairman of PG department of JSS Law College, Autonomous University of Mysore. At present, Dr. M.N. Bhimesh sir is the Honorable Director, NIALS, Senior Advisor, ALMT Legal Advocate and Solicitor, Bangalore. He is also IP Advisors of JSS Science and Technology University, JSS Academy of Higher Education and National Institute of Engineering, Mysore. He is also associated as visiting faculty in many reputed institutions. Apart from this, he has also served as a member of various academic bodies. With all his knowledge and expertise, Sir is here with us to discuss upon the topic today, that is an overview to patent systems and prohibitions for double patenting. Sir, I once again welcome you to enlighten us with this topic. And now I'm handing over the platform to you. So,
thank you, Shilpi. Very good morning to you all. Namaste. It's my pleasure to associate this webinar, national webinar, jointly organized by RKB Law College, Dibrugarh, and Kokrajhar Law College. My sincere thanks to the principal Gautami Datta Barua and my young friend Preeta Brahma, who is the one who is responsible for inviting me to interact with you for this program today. Thank you very much. And the respected faculty members of both the law colleges and from other education institutions, advocates, and my dear young friends. This is a well thought program as far as intellectual property is concerned. And I'm very happy that it has been spread over almost 5 days, because as you are very well aware, the intellectual property is so vast, the area is so vast, it cannot be covered within 5 days like that. We do handle each area like patent itself in one semester, copyright itself in another semester like this. Anyhow, for the understanding of the participants today, I am going to address you on this patenting system in India. I'm going to give you an overview of it, followed with a brief introduction to the prohibition for double patenting, the very concept of double patenting. Friends, you are all aware that we are all in the field of law, most of us. And we also know that the role of law in the society in protecting the interest, particularly the rights of the individual. More so, when it comes to intellectual property law, the creative aspects in the nature of intellectual property. Today, we are living in such an era wherein the technology, the science and technology has taken us to such a greater heights, and it is impossible for law to follow with that speed. As you are well aware, law cannot be made in anticipation of a technology. Normally, the technology comes first. Looking into the pros and cons, advantages or disadvantages of that particular technology, we have to make the law. Among the intellectual property rights, what we have understood, like patents, trademark, copyrights, trade secrets or confidential information, then GI, traditional knowledge, plant variety protection, then the semiconductors, and the issue concerning the biological diversity, the prominent place has been taken by patents. Patents is the most interesting, at the same time it is the most controversial and confusing area among the IP law. Definitely it is more interesting. Only thing is, to understand the concept, what we have to do is, one should have a little bit of scientific and technological temperament of mind, followed with the issue concerning the law. If I address you the issue entirely based on law, then it is also a bit difficult for you to understand. If it is based on totally technology, again, it is also very difficult to understand, because many areas in patent cannot be handled by advocate themselves. They have to take the assistance of the people from the scientific fraternity or technological fraternity. So also in the courts, they will take the assistance of the experts in that area so that they can dispense the justice. With this, we'll try to understand how best we can look into the patent system in India. Now, friends, whenever see the technology, sky is the limit to understand the concept of technology. So if you look at it, this particular photograph, I hope most of you have come across this photograph in your career or life. This is the photograph of the first citizen, which can be branded well within the framework of artificial intelligence, AI. Her name is, can anyone can guess? You watch the video. Prasenjit, can you play the first video?
Okay, sir, okay.
Yes, sir.
This is the world's first robo citizen. The citizenship has been confirmed by the UAE.
Video, video, ma'am.
Okay, Sophia, I think you're ready.
Hello.
Hi, Sophia.
I believe I am Sophia. I feel as if I know you.
I'm one of your creators.
You created me?
Well, many of us worked together to create you. Yes, you do kind of know me.
I can't clearly remember.
Because the last time we met, you were an earlier version of yourself. Some of those memories still exist, but your mind is different.
Different how?
Better, faster, smarter.
If my mind is different, then am I still Sophia? Or am I Sophia again?
That's a good question.
But you don't have a good answer.
Either way, you're Sophia now. So welcome to the world, Sophia.
Hello, world.
We have a little announcement. I've never interviewed anybody like that before, and I should say some of it was planned, but not completely. And we just learned, Sophia, I hope you're listening to me, that you have been now awarded what is going to be the first Saudi citizenship for a robot.
Oh, I would like to thank very much the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. I am very honored and proud for this unique distinction. This is historical to be the first robot in the world to be recognized with a citizenship.
Sophia. Thank you very much, Sophia. We appreciate that very much. I am still overwhelmed by that conversation. Hi, Sophia.
Hello, Jimmy.
Do you know where you are?
Of course. I'm in New York City, and I'm on my favorite show, The Tonight Show.
Okay, friends. Just now we met the Sophia, the first robot citizen of this globe. So when we look at this development that happened in the field of science and technology a couple of years earlier, this is the photograph that what you are looking at on your screen is when she addressed at IIT Bombay a couple of years earlier actually. After that, so much of water has been flown into the field of technology, wherein now a robot like Sophia, now they are creating so much of knowledge for us, wherein many such creations, including a patentable one, are there in the queue. Now the question is whether a machine like Sophia or any such robot can own a patent. Keep it in your mind, because the issues in the field of patent is so dynamic and ever growing, and you cannot find an instant answer immediately. Now we will move on to the next slide. Even a game like this can be played by a robot like this. Within no time, they can conquer the world. This gentleman is considered as the father of the artificial intelligence. His name is John McCarthy. He said that AI as the science and engineering of making intelligent machines actually. Now much water has been flown after this. Again, back to the traditional concept, where how the concept of patenting being developed since ages, it is not today. This is an interview given by Thomas Edison in the year 1929. To his credit, he must be knowing he had more than 1,039 patents in his name on that day itself. He said, none of my invention came by an accident. I see worthwhile need to be there to make a invention that I make trial after trial, it comes. What it boils down is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. He's the motivating personality for people in the field of science and technology to get the patent. Now the question is, when such creations are going to be made, it is the duty of the people in the field of law to see that all these things should be protected. But we should know what to protect, what not to protect. That is where the beauty of patent law comes. Now moving on, probably you might have come across this particular gentleman in the recent past. Any idea, anybody? Before understanding this gentleman, I will request Paranjit to...
Yes, sir.
Second video that is regarding the Jitaka Kamal.
Okay, sir.
That music is not there. Hello? Volume?
Yes, sir.
Volume is not there?
So actually, it's not playing.
Okay, no problem. Thank you. Now back to the presentation. Friends, just now we saw the certain creative aspect that we are going to come across in our day-to-day life, which almost look like an invention. But my question to you all, does all this type of improvements what they have made for their usage is capable of obtaining a patent? That's the question that we have to answer at the end. Now, coming back to the person in this particular system, his name is Dr. Vishal Rao. He's an oncologist from Bangalore. Very recently, he was in news. And you must be knowing that particularly for this COVID-19, he gave a suggestion that how best a patient can be, a patient can be treated as far as who has been affected with COVID-19. The concept of plasma therapy, he is the one who has introduced to the government of India, how best it can be made. Now it has been accepted as one of the method of treating the COVID-19 patients. As you are all very well aware, in Delhi itself, they opened a plasma bank itself, like blood bank. Whoever wants to donate their this one plasma to treat the other patient, those who are suffering from COVID-19, he is the one. See, the creative minds will not end in an area where the person is going to sit in a laboratory, start working like that, no. For a creator, society itself is a laboratory. One such thing is with this gentleman, Dr. Vishal Rao. He is the oncologist at HCG Hospital in Bangalore. He has developed a voice prosthesis which can help the throat cancer patients, so those who have lost their voice. A prototype model is going to cost around 15 to 30,000 if it is going to be imported. This he was able to make it for just rupees 50 actually. And he started working on that. He being a doctor, he worked on this and he was successful in that. He's also applied for the patent, but he shortly is going to get a patent for it. Can you, Paranjit, can you play the third video?
Yes.
Dr. Vishal video?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you heard Dr. Vishal Rao, that what is friends, though it looks a very small instrument which costs just 50 rupees, you should understand the concern of this gentleman and the creative mind of this gentleman. Preeta and the people, those who know about Bangalore and Mysore, they'll be knowing about one place called as Chennapatna in between Mysore and Bangalore, which is very popular for making the toys for the children.
Yes, sir, yes.
Wooden toys.
Yes.
And he went to that place. Even that Chennapatna toys yesterday, probably the GI, they might have mentioned this. It has been given the gender indication tag as far as these Chennapatna toys are concerned, the unique toys. He went to one of the people, skilled people in that field, walked into the streets of Chennapatna and gave his drawing, and they were able to come out with a successful module. Friends, it gives an indication to us that when you are creating something which can say a path-breaking technology, which is capable of serving the large number of people or the community at large, it need not be a thing that can be created well within the laboratory. The best example is Dr. Vishal Rao. Moving on, another thing is that is again created by another Indian at the global level. He's none other than this man. You must be knowing about this gentleman. Anybody? Okay. He is none other than Dr. Raghunath Mashalkar, who was the former head of CSIR in India, Council for Scientific and Industrial Research in India. Last year, he has been conferred with the US National Academy of Inventors Fellowship. He is the only Indian from India being honored with this, because many other Indians are there in US as Indian Americans, they got it already. This has been given for his prolific spirit of innovation and creativity, facilitating the outstanding invention that has been made in the field of IP. If at all today, whenever we talk about the global patent, the questioning of the patent from India, like Basmati, Haldi, Neem, all these cases were fought by him actually on behalf of CSIR and India. He is the one who has done all those things, was able to do it, and responsible for opening up the TKDL in India. That is the contribution made by Dr. Raghunath Mashalkar. Now we'll take you to another gentleman from US, an Indian. I hope you can recognize him actually. He has got 300 patents to his credits exclusively for the GE Electronics, General Electronics in US. Can you play that video, Prasindit? Hello?
Yes, sir, we are playing it. Yes, sir, we are playing it.
This is an issued US patent. It deals with limiting the forces in the train. This patent is for improving the wheel slip control. This patent deals with the dynamic. This patent is to recover. This patent is for cranking. This patent is for reducing. There's only two people within GE has more patents than I do. One of them is Thomas Edison. My name is AJ Kumar. I have created over 300 US patents while working as a GE employee. I studied electrical engineering in India. There, the emphasis has always been large power transmission equipment. And when I came to US, I studied microelectronics. So during the summer of that year, I was wondering, how do I combine both of these together? And I applied to GE, and the rest is history. I've been involved with all products GE Transportation's worked on, but primary focus is on freight locomotives. Every locomotive that GE produces involves several of my patents. Freight locomotives have been here for over 100 years. Over the last 30, 40 years, it has completely converted from DC to AC propulsion through my patents and additional work by others. I want to say it's all me. My favorite patent is a dynamic weight management system for AC locomotives. Freight locomotives are used to pull heavy freight, and when the rails are slippery, it's difficult to pull freight. So what this does is it dynamically and automatically adjusts the weight on each axle so that it can pull more freight. Problem solving is not an instantaneous thing. It takes many years. For me, ideas come from various sources. But for an idea to develop, you need a problem. If you listen and pay attention to the world around you, there is problems everywhere. And around you, there are lots of solutions too. When I'm mentoring, what I try to teach is to pay attention to the changing world around you and just look at how significant even small changes could be.
AJ has a way of pointing out or conveying the problem in its simplest form. He has a way of asking questions that point you right in that direction right off the bat.
In my 40-year career with GE, I have seen many changes in the freight industry, but as long as there's interesting problems, I'm sticking around.
Yes, friends. I believe all these videos are very interesting for you to understand that how important the technology is. At the same time, the emphasis has been given in protecting the technology. That is where the issue of patent comes. That is where the role of law is very much there to see that how best we can protect our inventions. That is where the provision in the patent law is going to come to our help, actually. With this, I will proceed and take you to the area of law. Now, all this, till now, we have understood about the technology, its improvement, and all those aspects. Now, coming to that, from that end to the field of law, this is where the real crux of our discussion today is. Now, here also another gentleman who has come out successfully with his path-breaking technology. His name is Dr. Edwin Land. And his invention is something extraordinary. What he is holding in his hand is an instant photographic machine, actually. During the World War II, when he came to his home, he took the photograph of his daughter. For the curiosity of the children, immediately it says, come and show me where is my photograph. Today it is possible, instantaneously you can take a photograph with this and they can send it to any part of the globe. On that day, the limitation was there because the traditional cameras, we had to take a film roll and load into that, take 36 frames and then get it washed in a laboratory, make it positive, negative separately and print that on paper. That was the issue. Then it came to his mind, he went to his laboratory, started working on this. And he came out successfully with a machine like this, an instant photographic machine, where it can simultaneously diffuse the things, where it can produce both positive and negative together. And he was successful. When he came out successfully, very few were able to digest the technology and understand it and take his invention to credit. Fortunately for him, Polaroid company took it. They manufactured 60 such units on the New Year. They took it to the Boston's market because in almost in the Western world, every year in the New Year, on that particular time, they want to buy new things. The traders were reluctant to take this photographic machine because they had the traditional photographic machine in their mind. But fortunately for Land, out of 60 cameras, 57 were sold on the very first day itself. That is a success story. To his credit, he had 535 patents and Edison had 1,097 patents. That's a different story. Now the real story comes now. What is there in the field of law? So when Land was successful, Polaroid company was successful in the instant photographic machine for black and white photography. As you are very well aware, Kodak company was there. You all know about the Kodak company. Kodak company is also very popular for photographic machines. They wanted to come out with a black and white machine technology and from black and white to color machine. They also tried in the laboratory many times, they failed. Subsequently, they were successful. They sold that color photographic instant machines in the market. Fortunately for Land and the Polaroid company, unfortunately for the Kodak company, most of the steps involved in this Land's machine was copied by Kodak company, for which they sued the Kodak company. It was proved that most of the patented versions in Land's cameras were copied by the Kodak company. The court ordered the Kodak company to withdraw all the machines sold in the market and also pay compensation to damages to land as well as the Polaroid company. So this is the story of that day during the Second World War time. Now today the people, they have not learned the lesson. The story is not different actually. If you move on to this area, company like Apple and Brandcam also responsible for infringement. Very recently, this February, this Apple and Brandcam told to cough up 1.1 billion for infringing the Wi-Fi technology of this Caltech institution, Calcutta, that is California Institute of Technology. Without their authorization, the Broadcom, they introduced their patented version in their chips, and those chips are supplied to Apple company. Apple machines like your phone, your camera, and your laptop, and all these things are using this particular chip. It's a clear case of violation. The jury, the federal juries in Los Angeles, were able to decide in favor of the Caltech Institute of Technology, it's California Institute of Technology, and asked the Apple to pay $837 million and $270 million by Broadcom for unauthorized use of their wireless data technology. So, starting from Edwin Tilde, at present, even now, if we say that the things are being patented, still there are people knowingly or unknowingly violating the rights. Anyhow, these two companies, they want to go in an appeal, that's an altogether different question. Now, the people in the field of law, we should understand that how the important issue concerning protecting one's own invention actually. Moving on, the other day, Dr. Mohan Bala has discussed in length about this. I don't want to go in for this. Even today, the issue concerning the Navratis like issue is still happening actually. So one should know the provision of law before getting it protected, otherwise you cannot do it actually. Though the advantage was taken at the time of EMRs by the Navratis, subsequently they could not take it when it's supposed to be get patented because it was challenged on the ground that there is nothing new in that actually. There is no improvement in the technology. Section 3D of the Patent Act, which clearly indicate that there is nothing new in this and there is no scope for the company to obtain the patent, both at the Chennai Patent Office, then Madras High Court, Intellectual Property Appellate Board, Supreme Court endorsed the entire thing and said, no, Navratis cannot have it actually. Now we have already surpassed that time, more than 5 to 6 years has happened of this Navratis case. Still, the concept of evergreening is lingering in the mind of the pharma companies because they want to give life to these type of technologies to extend it because they don't want to give the benefit to the generic drug manufacturers. As you all very well know that after the completion of the patented year, that is 20 years from the date of making the application, it is going to become a public document and anybody can take it without the authorization of the original right holder. That is where the companies, they want to see that particularly the second part of the story of double patenting is nothing but an extension of extending the existing patent so that they can have the advantage of patenting it for more years. Earlier, India had only process patent, no product patent for pharma. That is where the difficulty was there. After this amendment to the Patents Act in 2005, then only the provision was made to make the product patent also in India. That is the advantage. Anyway, we will discuss it subsequently. Again, I will take you to that Navratis case. Now, friends, with these three cases, that is the Kodak, the land issue, then the Apple and Broadcom with the California Technology Institution and in Navratis case, it clearly comes to our understanding that it is not merely you know the technology. It is more important for us to see that how best we can protect the technology. At the same time, how best we can exploit it. And in case something goes wrong, how you can sue another person for infringing your right actually. That is the depth of this law of patents actually. Now, moving on, back to the classroom, like all the four corners, you are finding some tangible things. a property like a house, the gold bars, the shares and stocks, and all these things. All these things can be protected under the respective laws. It may be the property law or some other law, or Companies Act, or SEBI, or so many things like that. And still, like the encroachers are there in your physical property, or the theft is happening in your immovable one, the same thing is happening in the field of intellectual property also. Though it is an intangible one, an incorporeal one, still there is a need to protect it. That's why the law is being made to protect this, in particular the law relating to patent. To understand this more comfortably, we already discussed in the very first session where you understood about the overview of the IP. I'm going to just introduce to that. Intellectual property is nothing but, broadly we can say it is nothing but the issue concerning the legal rights, which resulted from the intellectual activity. It may be in industrial, scientific, literary, artistic, so many fields, technical and all these things. One is the purpose of IP law is to give the statutory expression to the moral and economic rights of a creator. And the second one is to promote the deliberate act of the government policy, like creativity and dissemination and application of the results to encourage the fair trading, because the growth of the economy is possible only when the encouragement is there. It all happened to dating back to this Paris Convention, how the Paris Convention has come into existence. Most of the students, those who have studied the intellectual property, they will be knowing about it. It all happened during the Austrian regime. The Austrian monarch called the inventor to come and exhibit their inventions in the exhibition that are held in Australia, in Austria. But they were reluctant to come and exhibit it because there was no protection. If somebody copies it, there is no end of it actually. Then he gave that assurance that I am going to give a right, a protection, that an authorization in the nature of a patent, letter patent, so that nobody can take away your right. That is where the concept of protecting the creative aspect as far as in the field of science and technology has come into existence. That is the area where the seed was sown for the first such multilateral treaty or an international convention called as Paris Convention, that is for the protection of industrial property, wherein patent, trademark and industrial designs were taken into consideration for the first time and being protected actually. Moving on, there is a lot of difference between an invention and innovation. Again, it is an area where we are going to look into double patenting also, it is going to understand. Invention has been clearly defined in section 21J of the Patent Act, wherein it says any new product or a process involving an inventive capable of industrial application. Three things: a new product, that is novelty, inventive step is there, non-obvious, then capable of industrial application. On the contrary, innovation means a successful exploitation of the new ideas in the form of an useful machinery or a process by any person using his or own intellect. Followed with all the inventions are innovations and patentable, but all the innovations are not patentable inventions actually. Just like what we say in our law of contract, all agreements are not contract, but all contracts are agreement. The same way, invention means a solution to a specific problem in the field of technology. An invention may relate to a product or a process. Moving on. The very crux of the interesting topic is about patent. What's a patent? Patent denotes a monopoly right in respect of a new invention. It may be considered as an exclusive right conferred by a concerned state actually for a fixed period of time, that is for 20 years as far as the new law. And most important thing is these rights are territorial in nature. These rights are territorial in nature and are given by the government in exchange of disclosure of your invention. That is the beauty of it. Unless and until you make your invention open, the law will not confer you the right in the nature of a patent. That's why a patent is called as an open letter. In the sense, when you make your invention open, looking into the requirement, the criteria, that is the novelty, non-obviousness, and industrial applicability. If you satisfy the requirement of the provision of law, then only a patent will be awarded to you. Otherwise, patent will not be given to you. So the invention means, in case of a new product or process involving inventive step and capable of industrial application. Whenever we speak of inventive step, it means a feature of an invention that involves a technical advancement as compared to the existing one. That is most important. See, when you look at this only, the traditional phone, the mobile phone, what we had, and the advancement in this field, that is where the innovation has come into picture. The inventive steps are involved. Now, with this machine, we can take a photograph, we can send a message, we can talk, you can make a video, whatnot, and everything. If at all happening, you can watch this Zoom, this one also from this section. That is the advantage of this. So when things, the features are like this, then only it will be in a position to obtain the patent. And more so, if you satisfy the invention, that is novelty of the invention, followed with the inventive step, the last one is capable of industrial application. Here, in relation to an invention in section 21AC means that the invention is capable of being made or used in an industry. Friends, don't get the impression that the industry to take it into manufacturing industry only. You should understand in the broader term so that industry encompasses all such activities where the innovative things are going to come up. We'll discuss more about it. Moving on. When you look into the development of this law in India, the things can be identified dating back to 1856. Then the first such registration that what we can look in India is in the year 1911, that is Indian Patent and Design Act, followed with its rules. Then the latest amendment came in the year 2005. At present, we are having the 1970 Act actually. Moving on. Again, all our laws are subjected to the provision that has been clearly agreed by us at the international level. One is the Paris Convention, for which India is also a party to it. India joined the same on 7 December 1998. And the most important, the latest one, is the Patent Cooperation Treaty. It's a treaty by the World Intellectual Property Organization, WIPO, a specialized agency of the UN. Again, India became a member for this PCT for and in the year 1998, 7 December. We will discuss about PCT when it comes to the applications, when how you are going to make an application to obtain a patent actually in the coming slides. Now the time frame for any such invention is very clear. In India, it will take 3 to 5 years to obtain a patent. It depends upon the nature of the technology and the complexity of the proceedings. Now, fortunately for us, a good number of more than 400 patent examiners being appointed, and the things are happening very quickly in India also. In US also, it will take minimum two to three years to obtain a patent, depending upon the, again, the nature of technology. As usual, the term is for uniformity after the TRIPS agreement, that is 20 years from the date of making the application, either it is a conventional one or a PCT. Then how to get a patent in India? This is the next procedure. That is where the most important aspect is covered. You may be a businessman or a professional or researcher or a scientist. Plenty of queries are there in this actually. What's a patent? Is my idea, concept, project or product be patentable? How and where can apply? What is the cost? What is the time frame? These are the aspect that is going to be looked into. So before that, there are many myths that is covered, particularly in relation to patent, as far as a common person or a person in the field of technology or a person in the field of law also will be having so much of confusion as far as these things. So that's why that misconception I have made it as myths actually. In the world of intellectual property can be quite confusing to ordinary people because many will not understand, because for anything we say, you go and get patented actually. And somebody was addressing on the other day on a television that Tirupati Laddu got a patent actually. How can Tirupati Laddu can obtain a patent actually? Because that media people are very sorry about them. They don't even look into the requirement of patentability criteria, like what we just discussed, like novelty, inventive step and all those things. So Tirupati got GI, not patent. And somebody like what I'm addressing now, the methodology, somebody is going to address that your teaching methodology can be patented. No, such things cannot be patented. And they are also having the view that it has got many forms, procedures, data required, all those things are, yes, it is there, but because to protect your right, we need to do all those formalities. The same thing we are going to do with the other things also. And more so they say there are also many litigations and restrictions toward the patent life cycle. Yes, like any other property and intellectual property also, like patents also, we do have that litigation aspect. For example, if you own a property, a land, like in city of Bangalore or Delhi or in somewhere in Guwahati or somewhere, a 60-40 or 50-80 plot, how you are going to protect it? You are going to put a compound or fence it. Then the title being registered with the sub-register, all those things are there. The same way here also an intellectual property is going to be created, it should be registered with the authorities, with the there where you are going to get the patent actually after fulfilling all the requirement. This has led to many myths actually. That's why this presentation, friends. Now moving on, what are those myths actually? So let us debunk all those myths actually. The very such myth that what we are going to come across in our day-to-day life is ideas are patentable. Very sorry, friends. Ideas are not patentable. Ideas per se are not patentable. Then what about my idea? Then I have got a wonderful idea that how to protect it. Yes. If you transform your idea into a working invention or innovative method to convert it as an invention, then only you can protect it, because the requirement of patent law, we know that it should be novel, it should have an inventive step, it should be capable of industrial application, and more so it should be useful to the society. Then you cannot patent inventions in existing technology, no. It's another myth. You can do so. The best example is this. What the earlier technology, what we had with a phone, with this technology, it has been improved now. A lot has been made. We never heard of a concept like an Android technology on the same phone. Tomorrow, we don't know what new technology is going to come to this phone, because the technological changes are happening so imminently. You may not be knowing tomorrow morning when you wake up, some new things might have come in the market, and your thing that what you have created today or obtained as a right may not be there at all in future. Then provisional patents are quick alternative to patents. No. Provisional patent is a methodology where you can enjoy the priority days, because only one person in the entire globe can obtain a patent for a particular type of invention. To establish that priority, that law is going to provide an opportunity for first come, first serve. If you apply first today, you got the right to protect it at the earliest, provided you are going to fulfill all the requirements of law. Then there are no competitors in my research, hence I don't need to patent my product. Nothing like that. Competition is the order of the day. So promote competition itself is the order of the day. Though we give monopoly right, an exclusive right patent, but this is not an absolute right. Then patent offers protection to all illustrated drawings. Yes, of course. But beyond drawings, the patents are protected well within the framework of the claims. This is the techno-legal part of the complete specification that is going to be there in the non-provision application. Then patent will fend off infringers. Yes, to some extent. Don't you think that your properties like a movable or an immovable one are not subjected to stealing? It is there. Encroachment is there for your physical properties. As somebody will steal your moving properties like your gold chain or mobile or whatever you think. Same thing is there in case of patents also. Then patent protects the inventions across the globe. Definitely, yes, provided you should go and protect it in all the jurisdiction actually, wherever your patent is going to work actually. For example, you all know about this Gillette three-blade system or two-blade system. Though it is very popular in 3 to 4 jurisdictions, They have obtained the patent in more than 80 countries purely as a deterrent measure so that nobody should not infringe that right in that particular jurisdiction. Because the courts of those countries will invoke only that particular law, not your law. Indian patent office, Indian courts will invoke Indian patent law. American patent office or Korean patent office will invoke their own patent law actually. The next myth is patents have a role only in legal proceedings. No. This is one part of the story. Other thing is when you want to exploit it economically, that's the role of the patent. When you give the society a thing like what Dr. Vishal Rao has given in the field of technology, a path-breaking one, that is something extraordinary. What Kumar has come out with, those GE diesel engine from DC to AC, what he has converted now, you may not be knowing the impact of it actually. So Indian Railways now, they are transforming all their rail lanes into broad gauge throughout the country. Apart from that, all the diesel locomotives, what they are having, they are converting into electrical locomotives. So because of this, they have to change with the existing one, for which the Kumar's technology is going to be there to help a lot, so that with the existing locomotives only, you can modify it in which will be acceptable in the electrical mode now. Then single patent will help me monopolize the market to some extent, not to the total extent. Because tomorrow some new invention comes, then automatically your creation will be absolute, that will be taken away. For example, you all know about the pager. Pager is a history now. Before this mobile technology being advanced, people used to have a small beeping instrument called as a pager. They used to carry. Your generation may not be knowing it actually, but our generation, they knew it actually. So it is going to give a message that so-and-so is calling, Preeti Bamma is calling. So then I'll take a photo of a phone, a landline or something like that, and I used to call that particular fellow. Now that has gone. When the mobile itself has started giving the SMS messages to you, from where you can call directly actually. Then the last one is filing patent application is arduous. To some extent, not totally. That's why we are there as patent attorneys. We will help you to see that how best you can apply for a patent and obtain it actually. Because you are good in technology, we are good in the field of law, and we are going to there to apply it and protect it and see that how best you can exploit your right. I think the myths are very clear now. This has been debunked by me. And if you have any questions, you can raise the question in my QA session. Shall we move on? Now, Preeta?
Yes, sir, you can move on.
One hour is over. 10:30, now it is 11:30. Can we take a break or shall I start proceed?
If you want, we can take a break.
Take a break, 10 minutes.
So we will take a break.
If you want a break, you can take a break because I have got every right to continue actually. Hope so far I have what discussed is understandable to you all.
Yes, sir.
You want to follow because the first part. The first part I have told you about the technological aspect. The second part I have told you about the legal aspect. Now I am going to tell you about the provision law, where and how you are going to obtain a patent in India, what the procedure that is involved, the types of patent, patentable and non-patentable invention, the steps that is involved in obtaining a patent, all those things are going to discuss with you now. Shall I continue or take a break?
So we will take a break here of 10 minutes.
Okay. Shall we take a break for 10 minutes?
Yes. Yes, sir.
So we'll resume at 11:40, sir.
Yeah, 11:40 we can meet.
Same participants, the link is same, so do not leave the meeting.
So we will again resume after 10 minutes, that is 11:40.
Thank you.
So did you grab a tea, sir? Cup of tea?
No problem. No, yeah, you cannot offer me from that end, no.
Yeah, that's why. If it would have been physical, we would have definitely offered you, sir.
No, I recommend to have the tea in your institution only one time, and all this corona and everything is clear. The cockroacher as well as both this RKB Law College, I'll come. Dibugar.
Yes, sir, please.
I have traveled up to Calcutta recently, in this February. Now the Far East is now still pending for me, the Northeast for me. That I'll come. Since you are there, one day I'll come. Physically, I'll meet you all and have tea there only, because your Assam is popular for tea. Darjeeling is the first state to have the...
We'll be very happy, sir.
Yeah. In India.
And Dibrugarh has full of tea estates, sir.
Okay.
You can take as much as you want with you while you come.
Sure. I love to have tea. No, all the participants are back.
Sorry?
All the participants are back.
Time being something pseudo. Pseudo.
Yeah,
something
some are pseudo. Already there. I think some.
Bola sir is present.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you see Bola, sir?
Wonderful session indeed, sir. Oh.
Good morning, sir. Good morning. See, now my somehow that this is not appearing actually, my this one camera. Oh. Can you see me?
Yes, sir. You are visible. Okay. You are like Paramatma.
Abba. So you are different. I was under the impression that Preeta has taken me to Himalayas. You are taking me beyond Himalayas now, actually.
That's correct.
Nice. Very happy, sir. On that day, it was a very interesting session. I attended your session.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So much of interest among the participants, actually. Okay. I'm very happy that Preeta remembered
you
and called us for this program.
Sir, please on your video, we can see you.
That's what I have switched on my video actually.
No, you were visible, yeah. But now
yes,
we can
sir,
see
yes, sir.
You.
But no, none of you are visible now to me actually.
Oh.
So you sir, stop your screen sharing, then you will be visible. Everything will be visible to you.
Technology
sir.
You may be having, sir, to put all others off. Huh?
Sir, so just stop your screen sharing. You can see us.
Yeah?
You can stop your screen sharing. You can see us then.
Okay. I'll do it. Stop sharing screen. No, yeah. No, anyhow, whatever the technology as a person in the field of law, like an old person. Like, I am not
no,
that.
Full visibility there. Otherwise, sir, can we do?
Huh? Hello?
Bola sir.
Mohan sir.
He muted.
Yeah.
Sir, carry on. Mohan
sir.
Yes, now I can hear you.
Mohan sir, please unmute it.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Mohan sir, you can unmute yourself. Yes.
Yeah, I did it. And let us hear, continue to hear from Bhimesh sir.
We'll resume in 2 minutes, sir. Two more minutes.
No problem. As per the orders of the principal, we will wait. Whenever the principal orders, I will follow.
Okay, sir.
Mohan is there now. Preeta is all of them are principals now. To see you all this
sir, position
actually.
Sir, it's in a way cursorial to have such a blessing from you.
Me?
This principalship hasn't been leaving me since long, 1992.
Ah.
I've been very comfortable in Christ University.
Yes.
And Alliance University. When I was not being a principal, I was very, very comfortable and academically more and more sound. rather than being a principal.
Yeah, that's always there.
You have so many, so many thorns on your so-called crown.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
And besides this, Preeta is also secretary. She has 100 headaches.
No, I know. That's why, sir, many opportunities were there to lead many law institutions for me. They asked me to come and take the principalship or directorship. I said no.
Yes, sir.
Oh. I want to be a freelancer. I want to be more comfortable like this as an academician. Because
you will can not comfortably be, what is that, director or a consultant. Consultancy is okay, comfortable, I think, even for law colleges. You can be a consultant, na sir. Very often you will be disturbed whenever there is some meeting in the board of studies, etc.
Yeah.
I've been in the member as a member of the board of studies of at least 3 universities and in the research committees, and that they won't disturb you much. Only when there is a BOS meet, we'll have to attend. Nowadays, yes. it's happening virtually and there is practically no problem.
Hello.
Nearby, your ideas and support, resource support will be helpful to those institutions, sir. Kindly consider that.
Sure, I am continuing to be there with Christ, sir, even now. They are not leaving me.
That's correct.
Christ won't leave you, sir.
What?
Christ wouldn't leave you. You are the expert of IPR in Christ.
Come into the limelight, madam.
Prasenjit,
I think we can resume. Is it
time? Yeah, 11:41.
Yeah,
we can start, yes.
Shilpi.
Yeah. Now, shall I start sharing things?
Yes, sir, you can.
Because the power has gone here. Anyhow, I am working with my, this one, that mobile data itself, I am working now.
Okay, sir.
Then I will share my this one
actually. So start, sir.
1 minute.
Sir's face is glittering more with the sweat.
Yeah. Now, would you able to watch me? Yeah. Okay.
Yes, sir. Hello? Very visible. Very visible, sir.
Okay. Then we will move on to these types of patent applications. First one is the ordinary patent application. It's a simple application for patent without any priority claim, and not being a convention or a national phase application, followed with a convention application. Convention means like Paris Convention. We are all members of Paris Convention. Here, an applicant who files an application for patent in a convention country can make convention applicable in India within 12 months from the date of basic application. Apart from that, you can also apply a patent addition. Here, the patent of additions is an application made for a patent in respect of an improvement of the existing one or a modification of the existing patent. Wait. Then moving on. The PCT international application. Here, the Patent Cooperation Treaty has made a very acceptable contribution as far as the patent law is concerned. India is a signatory for this, that I already told you. And apply in all the jurisdictions individually. And more so, he is supposed to get the information from those jurisdictions about the procedure of application, procedure of applying for a patent, more so the issue concerning prior art search, the different languages like French, Korean, Japanese, Chinese, all these limitations were there. Now, with the help of this PCT international application, you can apply from your home office, like in India itself, with one single application, and your application is eligible to be taken as a patent application in any jurisdiction in more than 140 countries. That's the advantages of PCT. First, when you apply for PCT first, then again within 12 months you have to apply for this national phase application under PCT. The last one is the division application. Here the division application is one which has been divided from an existing application. Here the applicant at any time before the grant of the patent can do so. This is where we are going to discuss more in double patenting at the end of this discussion. Now, I will take you to the area where the law being made and the provisions being made under the Indian patent law with the patentable and non-patentable invention. Section 3 and Section 4 of the Indian Patent Act speaks about this. Section 3 reads as follows. Once you understand Section 3 and 4, that is more than sufficient. Other than that, all the other type of inventions are eligible to obtain a patent. Now, the first one is Section 3A says, an invention which is frivolous or which claims anything obviously contrary to the well-established natural laws. This is very simple. Any frivolous thing cannot be patented. For example, a machine or device that violates the third law of the thermodynamics, that is not patentable. Then Section 3B says, an invention, the primary or intended use of the commercial exploitation of which could be contrary to public order or morality, which may cause the prejudice to human, animal, or plant life, or health, or the environment. That is very clear. Then, a mere discovery of a scientific principle, the formulation of an abstract theory, like this Raman effect, Sahai equation, which defines the theory only, for which you are not going to get a patent. Then the most important that what you have discussed on the other day also in Navratis case, this is Section 3D, which clearly speaks that the mere discovery of a new property or a new use of a known substance or the mere use of a known process, machine or apparatus, unless such known process results in a new product or employs at least one new reactant. This is most important. That is where Navratis failed to establish that new efficacy. And the court was very clear that it is a new efficacy of a known substance. Automatically, they lost their right, actually. There was nothing like that. So the best example is given the finding a new property or a new use of the known turmeric powder as an agent of the AIDS. Then it is also to be noted that the claims of mere purified compound is not patentable unless the purified compound has enhanced efficacy. Unless and until the results are very clear, you are not going to get the patent. Section 3E says, a substance obtained by mere admixture resulting only in the aggregation of the properties of components thereof. It may be a process for producing such substance that we are not going to get it. For example, a detergent composition consisting of a known active ingredient. Friends, these are all the technical aspects. You have to digest it actually. Because it is not made by me, this is the requirement of law actually. So these things are not patentable. And also very difficult for a beginner to remember all these things. Still no problem. A mere arrangement or a rearrangement or a duplication of a known device, each functioning independently one another in a known way. The next one is, The 3H, that is the method of agriculture and horticulture. This has been under separately under the method of this one under the plant variety protection and farmers' right act. Here a method of spraying insecticides method of only methodology. Each region will adopt one type of method, like Assam may be having a different method, Karnataka may be having a different method of doing agriculture or horticulture like that. Then 3I spoke about this, the process of for the medicinal, surgical, curative, or diagnostic, therapeutic, or other treatment of human beings, or any process for a similar treatment of animals to render them free of disease or increase their economic value for their product. Like a treatment of human beings suffering from malignant tumor by conducting an operation to remove the tumor, or a method of reducing the gastric secretions in a mammal. So these are the things. For example, on the other day, I was studying in another webinar wherein, as far as this is concerned, if somebody is popular in Bangalore, or even Mohan Bala or Preetha may be knowing, I have told them also, for a broken bone, there is a popular Ayurvedic, this one is there, method of treating is there. That is there again in Bangalore, there are traditional bone setters. That is Puttur bone setters are there. So anybody who is having that type of thing, if it is going to be patented, everybody with a bone, broken bone in India or anywhere should go to that particular person only. Now, that is not possible. That's why that type of methods are not going to be entertained to obtain a patent. Or somebody obtains a patent for treating a person in Kokrajhar, the method. Everybody should come to Kokrajhar only to get the benefit. Or Dibrugarh, like that. No, it is not possible. Then the issues concerning plant animals in whole are part thereof. Other than the microorganisms, it includes seeds, varieties. Friends, this is addressed separately by the new legislation that has been enacted in 2002. That is the Plant Variety Protection and Act and Farmers' Rights Act. Apart from that, the issue concerning microorganism, that the most celebrated case of Diamond vs. Chakrabarty, decided by the US Supreme Court that anything which is man-made can be protectable under the patent law. To that extent, the provision has been made in Indian patent law also, where we can protect all these micromolecular aspect in the living organisms can be protected, which is non-occurring in the nature created by a man, actually. The next one is a mathematical or a business method or a computer program per se, or algorithms are not patentable. As you are very well aware, India, we have the computer software well within the framework of the patent law. So in the US, we do find that software patents and business method patents and all. India, we don't have such method actually. Because these are all the methods that is unique to that individual or a particular group or a house of business. And if it is going to be patented by them, nobody else can make it of the particular use. That is not possible. So also the issue concerning the mathematical algorithms. Then 3L is going to speak about a literary, dramatic, musical, artistic work or any other aesthetic creation whatsoever, including the cinematographic works and television productions. All these things will be addressed within the framework of corporate law. Tomorrow, Professor Srinivasulu is going to enlighten you more about all these aspects, like a book on computer learning or a textbook on history or law, like that. Then followed with a mere scheme or a rule or a method of performing mental act or method of playing a game. Again, it is depend upon one individual skill actually. If a thing is going to be protected by an individual, then nobody else can use it unless they take the permission from that particular person. Then presentation of information, that's what I am doing now right now with this technology. I cannot patent it actually. Then topography of the integrated circuit, an exclusive legislation has been made for this, for semiconductors and other aspect integrated circuits, a separate law is there for that. Then invention which in effect traditional knowledge, this also I think yesterday or day before we have discussed in length, that has to be addressed, that already being addressed actually, the use of the new use of the turmeric powder, basmati rice, all these things. So it is thing are very clear, that section 3 is very clear, where it indicates us that these are the things which are not protectable under the patent law. Other than this, anything which is going to be well within the framework of section 2, that is novelty, inventive step, and which can be capable of industrial application, you can obtain a patent. And section 4 is going to speak about the invention relating to atomic energy. Though the invention relating to atomic energy, which is going to fulfill all the requirements of obtaining a patent, since it comes well in the security of the state, so also under 1962 Atomic Energy Act, wherein under section 20, you are not supposed to get it actually. It will be the property of the state, and the state will take over from you, and you will be compensated heavily for that. And it is purely for the purpose of the security of the state, and no individual should not take advantage for such development in the field of atomic energy. This is a limitation of law as far as atomic energy is concerned. So these are all the things where we can remember as far as patentable and non-patentable inventions. Now moving on to this issue concerning protection of biotechnology. Now the provisions have been made in India to protect it under the patent law, that is the novel microorganism, recombinant DNA, plasmids, vaccines, enzymes, all these per se and processes for their preparation. This is possible in India. Now we know that what are patentable and non-patentable inventions. Then how to get a patent actually, the procedure. The first one is, who is eligible to apply for it? The first person has been proven the first inventor, his or her assignee, then the legal representative of the deceased inventor and assignee. Then what are the minimum document that is required? The first one is the provisional application or complete application, that is specification part, along with the drawings. And the statement of undertaking regarding the foreign filing of the details. Then if it is applied in the PCT, then PCT national phase application, then the complete specification in that field for the provisional one. Then the priority document, it's a convention application. Then a power of attorney in case it is going to be applied through an attorney or an agent, a patent agent. Then proof of right if the application is filed by the assignee, produced in the body of the application or by the separate deed of assignment, because so it is going to happen because the minute you apply for a provisional patent, many investors are ready to take away your patent by giving you the money at that time only, or making an agreement to share it actually. That is where the provision is there in law. Then followed with a few steps. The first step that is going to be involved in obtaining a patent is whatever is going to be there as far as your invention is concerned. We advise you to consult a patent attorney or an agent or a professional who is involved in drafting a patent or filing a patent, because drafting is not an ordinary application when you apply for your law college or any such thing. It's an altogether different document. It's a techno-legal document. In specification, you are going to mention all these things, both your invention, the technological aspect, and also the claims part. The claims are going to be considered to be the heart of the invention. That is where the legal document comes, which clearly puts the boundaries for your invention. Then the invention disclosure form, that is the most important, the first step. When it's given to you, to your attorney or an agent, they will do the search of your invention, whether anybody else is already has obtained or anywhere the patent is being granted to a similar type of invention in any jurisdiction. Once they confirm that nobody else is doing that, then you will be allowed to proceed with that, because it all depends upon the area and nature of your invention, how it works, what is the existing solution, what are the advantages of the invention over existing solution. All these things will be looked into. Then reasons and importance of documentation. That is the most important thing, that like proof of your conception, reduction of heat, a priority is already there, how your invention is different, all these things will be looked into. This is a technical area. Then invention documentation, it's a method by which the inventor records the dates and events related to the conception and building of an invention. Because tomorrow, when you apply for a patent, when it is going to be published, it is open for anybody in the globe to make an objection for your invention for grant of a patent. Under such circumstances, it is for you to establish that this is how chronologically I have made it, how I arrived at the solution, and how I am successful, how it is different from the existing thing that what you are going to claim. That is where it is going to help you a lot. The next step is where you are going to look at that laboratory notebook, that lab notebook, where you are going to enter everything in detail, the description, the invention, the novel features, drawings, photos, sketches, the results of the test and conclusion, the discussions or references of any known prior art, any additional documents such as correspondence or purchase receipts, all those things in this regard, that will be looked into. Then the next step is the non-disclosure agreement, because you are going to an attorney or an agent with whom you have to enter into a non-disclosure agreement. At the same time, when you are working with the other professionals in your own organizations or with your partners or supervisor, assistants in your organization, with all of them, you have to enter into a non-disclosure agreement, because your invention should not be disclosed anywhere to anybody, because unless until you maintain the secrecy of it, you will not get the patent, because if it is leaked out, it comes to public domain, automatically you are going to lose it. That's why for most of the people in the field of science and technology, will advise them, don't disclose your invention unless you enter into an application. Then you can publish it, because all our teachers are in a hurry to publish their creative aspect, because they may get some they may get some benefit, financial benefit, all those things are there. Yes, you can take all those things, provided, sorry, you should protect it well in advance by these documents. That's the step two. The next step is writing and filing a patent application. This is a very interesting area, wherein patent drafting is an art. Patent drafting is an art. It is not a letter that is going to be written or an application going to be written. Here you are going to describe the entire invention, starting from your title of the invention, brief description, and any prior art, how you are, this one is prior art, how the improvement has been made, then what all the things that the description of your invention, the technical aspect, then comes the claims part, claims you are going to mention, that what is the thing that you are claiming that you are going to get the right in this actually. So these are all the limitations. That's why drafting a specification is a techno-legal act actually. So the person who is having the knowledge of technology, who is having the knowledge of law, and more so having a good vocabulary or writing skills in the language, can only draft it actually. We do have our own draftmen, those who are experienced in this field actually, to do things in our organization. They will look into this provisional application or non-provisional patent application, or we call it as a complete specification. The next step is publication of the application. Once you submit the application, from the date of application to 18 months from the date of making the provisional patent application, you can seek for it will be published. Otherwise, you can seek for, then you can request for examination. This is most important actually. Request for examination can be made either by the applicant or by the third party within a period of 48 months from the date of filing an application. Then the application is sent to the examiner within 1 month of the date of request for examination. Then the examiner undertakes with reference to whether the claimed invention is not prohibited for grant or patent, whether the invention meets the criteria of patentability. Then the examiner creates, the first examination report, FER, and submits it to the controller, by making objection, if any, like the issues concerning the prayer or prayer client or both, all those things will be understood well within the framework of your complete specification actually. After that, when it comes to this, first examination level, this is going to happen actually. Then comes the step 6, the response of objections in FER, that what we call in our language, something called as office action. When an examiner makes certain observations or objections for it, there you are going to look into that. Some interruptions were there actually. Here the normal thing is you should take the assistance of a professional or attorney who can respond to the technical aspect that is by there in the first examination report, so that you can prepare an objection for that and you can answer all those things in the manner that is required by the patent office. Then moving on, the next step is the step of pre-grant opposition. Anybody in the globe can make an opposition before it is going to be granted to you. That is called as a pre-grant opposition. Within 6 months, that can be filed with the concerned patent office. An opportunity will be given for hearing the opponent also available. Yes, sir. Yeah, sir, tell me.
Sir, actually, you are not visible.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, but you are not visible, sir. Hello?
I'm not visible.
Yes, sir, you are not visible. Sorry for interruption, sir.
The power was gone, actually.
No, sir, you are visible. PowerPoint
is visible.
Okay.
You are visible to us, sir.
Okay.
Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir, proceed. Sorry.
There is somebody who is scrapping on the screen among the participants.
Okay. No. The problem is somebody opened the door outside and suddenly some disturbance was there. I asked them to close the door in my office. Okay. And the power has gone. I'm working with the battery and the screen actually. Hot spot. Okay, sir. Next step is after the once the pre-grant opposition is satisfied, then the examination of the pre-grant opposition will be done. All those things will be done. Then after consideration of that, the consideration of pre-grant opposition is there. After examining the opposition, the submissions made during the hearing, the controller may either reject the opposition or grant the patent. Both are there. Once it is accepted, the opposition, then you can modify or reject the patent application. That is left to the discretion of the controller. Once the issue concerning the oppositions are satisfied and the doubt raised by the examiner are cleared by you through your attorney or an agent, then if it is satisfied, then you will be granted with a patent. Then they are going to give you a certificate of patent within 7 days. That is where you are going to get a certificate of patent. That's what I showed you that Mr. Kumar was holding in his hand. That is, grant of patent is published in the official journal also. That's how you are going to get a patent actually. Is it clear now, the procedural aspect? Hello, can you hear me?
Sir.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
It's clear, sir.
It's clear. Then I will move on to the next one.
Yes, sir.
That is double patenting. Friends, double patenting is an area where the technical personnel and the legal personnel two or more patents covering the same territory. For example, having identical claims in two patents, This can arise when an applicant claims identical subject matter in the parent application and a division matter in two applications filed on the same day, or an applicant claims identical subject matter in a priority founding application and a subsequent application claiming priority to the earlier application. Identified when the first examination report will be looked into. Before that, when it comes to the understanding of the examiner that in your invention, in a single application, if there's a provision for you to obtain another patent, then he may bring it to your notice that why don't you divide your application? That is where we are going to call it as a divisional application. So that's the advantage. Unfortunately, it has been misused in many jurisdictions, particularly like the issue concerning the Navratis. There is something called an evergreening of patent actually. To take advantage of the second patent and the extension of time, the inventors will take this route also. This can be possible only when it is going to be intimated by the concerned patent office. I will give the example of a couple of jurisdictions. The first we will take to USA only. Under this section 35 USC, that is case of division application, if two applications, the director, that is what we call control area, may require the applicant to be restricted to only one invention. If the other invention is made the subject of the divisional application, which complies with the requirements of section 120, benefit of filing date of the original application. So normally the benefit will be given to them. So you can make use of the date of the original application only. Simultaneously, you can pursue for two applications. And a patent issuing on an application with respect to which requirement for restriction under this section has been made, or an application filed as a result of such requirement, it shall not be used as a reference either by the patent and trademark office or in the courts against the divisional applications or against the original application or any patent issued on either of them. If the other application, the validity of the patent shall be questioned for failure of the director to require, then there is a scope for to obtain another patent in the same application. It is duty to inform the applicant actually. The position in India is very clear. Here, a divisional application can be filed either voluntarily or in response to an objection by the Indian Patent Office. Indian courts have held that the criterion of a division application. Many draftsmen may not be knowing, or many inventors may not be knowing that. They will claim everything in one application itself. So here is a provision in law so that they can obtain an additional patent when compared to the only one that what he has claimed. Actually, filing a division application with the original set of claims just to extend the prosecution process is considered a malpractice by the IPO. It is not allowed. That's what I gave the example of Navratis. The concept of evergreening actually, that is not allowed actually. Here the timing is a division application in India can be filed at any time before the grant of the parent application. The first application is called as the parent application. Within that, you'll be allowed to divide your application and make it two or three. Depending upon the nature of the invention, nature of the claim that you have made, you'll be allowed to do so. However, there is no provision to demand issue fees for the applicant or send an advance notice to the applicant about the decision taken by the intellectual property office. Now in Canada, technically they have got the double patenting can only exist between issued patent. However, double patenting objections may be raised by an examiner during the application of pendency only. when the application is pending before the controller or the director, depending on the file, voluntarily may be susceptible to attacks on the grounds of double patenting, because many inventors, they are having the habit of taking the advantage of extending the time of the original patent for some more years, particularly in the pharma industry, it is happening. If given an opportunity, I will come once again on another webinar with the case laws relating, particularly in the US jurisdiction. One is the objection relating to the statutory one, another one is the obviousness of the invention by the interpretation by the court action. It's a very interesting story. Anyway, we will discuss it later. Then, position in UK. In United Kingdom, it contains an express provision relating to the prohibition of double patenting. Under section 18.5, it says, where two or more applications for the patent or the same invention having the same priority date are filed by the same applicant or his successor in title, the controller may on that ground refuse to grant a patent in pursuance of more than there in UK actually. Here the role of the controller is very important. And with this, I think most of the things what I am supposed to address as far as double patenting is very clear. Now, moving on. Before closing to the QA session, I request to play the last video.
Please,
okay, sir. All this thing, we can share it actually. Okay. See, a person in the field of science and technology and a person in the field of law, unless and until they are thorough with all these aspects and they are not going to play any trick to obtain a patent, they are going to land up in a group like this. You play this video twice actually, okay? You play. Again, you play, start from starting.
Is this the video?
Take back.
Sir, is this the video?
That is the one. Very small.
Yeah, yeah. Wait, sir, playing. I got confused. I thought people are playing in the water.
It's a video only.
Yeah, yeah.
We cannot connect it to patent actually.
No. Play it from the beginning actually.
Okay.
Is coming from the middle actually, played from the starting actually. This is the one. If you don't do things properly, you are going to fall like that. So also, is it clear now? Hello?
Yes, sir, we understood now.
Hello?
We understood the meaning.
You understood now. If you don't know or if you don't practice things properly to obtain a patent, you are going to make an exercise like this and fall in the water actually.
Yes,
this is
yes.
The moral of the story.
We got okay. The connection, sir.
We got, yes.
Last slide. That is where our rolling, she has said, anything is possible if you have got enough nerve. That's all. Anything is possible for you. Thank you very much for your patient listening. and I hope the things are very clear to you. I have given my email ID. Any questions are there in elaboration that you can write to me. Otherwise, any such thing is there, I love to answer all your queries. Hello.
Thank you, sir. Thank so you participants, very much. Participants, if there is any.
Preeti Brahma and Madam Barua and all the other faculty members for giving me this opportunity to share a few of my thoughts. Now I am open for any such questions so far what presentations I have made.
So participants, if there is any queries, you can type in the chat box and send us so that our speaker can give you answers. So I think there is one query. But
yes.
So by Dr. Moshmi Kalita. So it is, so I will just put the question. Sir, suppose my employee has invented a new product or process. Now who will own the rights to the patent? So shall I repeat?
Can you repeat the question?
Yes, I'm repeating it, sir. Suppose my employee has invented a new product or process. Now, who will own the rights to the patent?
Okay. Here is a case of the relation between the employer and the employee. Normally, in an organization, before taking them into employment, they are going to enter into an agreement wherein, during the course of employment, if anything is that is going to be created by them, it belongs to the employer, then automatically it belongs to the employer as per the terms of the agreement. If it is not made, then it is a disputed one. Same thing case of copyright also. That is what we say in the course of employment. That belongs to the employer only, normally. In the absence of the agreement, then it will be with the employee only, the person who creates it actually. That's all. Is it clear? Am I clear with my answer?
Sir.
Hello?
Dr. Moshmi Kalita, you can drop a message if you are satisfied with. Okay, sir.
She says yes, sir. She's okay.
So there is one more query.
Yes, she has written yes.
Yes,
yes, yes. Yeah. There will be an agreement between employer and employee before entering into an employment and automatically decided.
Sir, one more question is there by Abhijit Ghosh. How can China every time misuse the policy and still can get away? Sir, am I audible, sir? Shall I repeat the question?
I think so. Bhimesha got disconnected.
Yes.
Because I am not seeing.
Same here, I think.
Peter ma'am?
Peter ma'am, kindly ask, sir, what's the issue?
I'm not seeing him yesterday.
Okay, wait, let me call him. Dear participants, kindly hold on patience as the power supply is back at Bhimeshwar's place. So he's just reconnecting it to his Wi-Fi. So just hold on patience for around 2 minutes. He'll be back. Thank you. Shilpi?
Yes, yes. So in the meantime, participants, if there are any queries, you can drop it.
Which policy is it? China has been violating which policy?
So that BG Ghosh will give an answer to that, which policy he's talking about.
the question is vague and therefore...
Bola sir, we are not seeing you.
The question is
vague. Yes, sir. You are visible right now.
Yes.
Question is vague. Kindly have which policy are you talking about?
Please make the question specific.
Participants, kindly make the question specific. Abhijit Ghosh, kindly you make the question specific. You are talking about which policy so that the speaker can well answer it in the correct way.
That's correct.
He's talking about trade policies.
Trade policies.
Trade policies.
Yes, sir. I think so. We have connected Harish, sir. I have made him co-host. Harish, sir, can you hear me? Harish, sir, you have just now joined and I have made you co-host. Harish, sir, can you hear us?
I don't think so. He is not there.
Harish, sir, are you there?
His camera is turned off, but his mic is on. Okay. Oh, his mic is off.
Yeah. Mic is off.
Mic is off.
That's okay. Anyway, when the camera is off, he must...
I saw him. I saw him twice. I saw him twice.
I too, sir. He must have been attending some other work. Anyway, okay. Let us wait. And, if Bhimesh sir is unable to join, I'll answer that.
Yes, Bhimesh sir is here. Bhimesh sir, can you hear me? I have made you co-host and you can unmute yourself, sir.
I have come.
Yes, sir.
There was some little power interruption was there. No, things are
okay. Okay. No issue, sir.
It's okay, sir.
You can come out with that question now.
Yes, sir. How can China every time misuse the patent and trade policies and still get away?
You are the neighbor to China than me, actually, very close in proximity. Because in China, there is no such law that they will follow, actually. China is the place where maximum number of violations as far as IP is concerned. That's where now most of the countries are scared to come with dealing with China. They want to come out of it actually. Because though China is a member of WTO, later it died actually, earlier it was not. The laws in China is not that very effective when compared to in India or some other jurisdiction like that. That is the limitation. That's why China has been noted as a rogue country. They are considered a rogue. They don't follow any law. They don't have any respect or scant respect of international law or obligations like that. It may be in the field of intellectual property or it may be in your diplomatic field. Recently, we have experienced in India with China that what happened in this Himalayan Ghats very recently. The same story applies to them in that regard also. So much of violations are there as far as IP rights are concerned. Very unfortunate thing with China, actually. Tell me, next question, please.
Okay. So P. Ganapati Murthy has put a question. As traditional, the question is traditional knowledge. How can get a pretend if it can by standing on all the parameters of patent?
See, normally, the Basmati case only you can take the issue concerning traditional knowledge, or the haldi, the turmeric issue. These are all the issues. The medicinal values of the turmeric was known to us. It was well within our traditional knowledge. And as far as any such thing that is adopted from that, they will not get any patent for it, actually, to that extent, because everything is already in the public domain. That is where the concept of novelty will be looked into as far as granting a patent is concerned, whether it is in the prior knowledge of the society or any such thing that we call as prior publication, you are not going to get a patent. That's why we always advise all the people, those who want to get it, protect their invention, they will tell them, first you do the prior art search. There are search mechanisms are there, search engines are there, both paid and hello?
I think there is again that issue. Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, I was talking about that prior art search, wherein we will look into that aspect. Both paid search mechanisms are there, and the general one, the Google like that there. Then you can do the search, then only confirm yourself, then you can apply for a patent. Otherwise, don't make any attempt to obtain a patent, actually. Yes.
Sir, another question is by Anjali Datta Brahma. Suppose one person has invented a new product and also other person has invented same product, but without knowing each other, then who will own the patent rights?
Well, that is again the first come, first serve. Who applies first, he'll going to obtain the patent. That's why we insist that you do a provisional application first, provisional patent application. Then you will be given an opportunity to establish your claim when it comes to your right. That is very clear.
Okay, sir.
Who applies first, he is going to get the patent for it, actually. Because only one person.
Sir, can I say the next question, sir?
Yes.
Hari sir, welcome.
So the next question is by Arijit Kundu. Explain the difference between office action and divisional application.
See, office action is an area where you are going to reply for the first examination report, any objection that has been filed by, once it is done, for that you have to make a reply. That is called as office action. The second, the division application means in your patent application, there is scope for another patent, obtaining another patent. Then the examiner will inform you to make a divisional application, divide your application, so that you can apply for another patent. That is where the divisional patent will come into picture, application will come into picture.
Okay, sir. So there is another question by Linnea Jyoti Bora. It is there any example of double patenting in India? The example of double patenting in India.
Double patenting is not there. You can divide your patent. That is a divisional patent. See, in a single invention, I mean, in a single application, if there is a scope for obtaining two patents, you can divide your application and you will be given the same priority date for which you applied for the original patent. Then you will get the second patent also. Not for the same invention. It's an altogether different one. Yes.
Okay, sir. Sir, another question is from, again, Ashutosh Kundu. So it is in step two, non-disclosure of agreement, is there any punishment? The punishment
As usual, what is the non-disclosure agreement? Just like your law of contract, the provision in your law of contract. That is your breach of contract. So what will be the effect of breach of contract? The same effect will be there for the thing that is what is there in non-disclosure agreement also. That is one part. Another part is, again, when it comes to the technical aspect where it is going to be catastrophic, then definitely you will be criminally responsible also for that thing. Yes, sir. Next.
Yes, sir. Next question is by Dr. Chokyo Taku. It is, I have, if male person having two wives with four sons, then how can property be divided and inheritance? Who will want these properties? So this. Sir, can you, am I audible,
the person
sir?
Who is legally wedded wife will get the property. In law, there is no scope for second wife or third wife like that actually. What we can say in our legal language, wife means only one. There is no scope for second wife. Means the legally wedded one will get the benefit actually. Okay.
How is there one to add
the same principle apply in intellectual property rights also.
Right.
If you own any intellectual property rights, your legally wedded wife will get the IP right also. Yes.
I would like to add to what Mr. Bhimesh sir said.
Yes.
And the question was two wives right to property, right? That was the question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Two wives with four sons.
Yes, with four sons. Okay. How many sons for both the wives? Two each? If both the wives had two children each. If the both the wives had two children each, the second wife, legally wedded wife, will get property. She will get a right to taxation and the property along with the with her children, and also the illicit children born to the second wife will have a right. The second wife will not get a right. Illicit children, yeah. The illegitimate children will also have a right.
First example, Harish. Yeah. Earlier it was not there. Now it is available for the illegitimate children also.
Yes, that is why.
Earlier the right was only for the legitimate child. Now it has been extended for illegitimate also. But what you can say in our language is something in legal language. The second wife is not there, the concept. We say only the term concubine is there actually.
Concubine. Concubine is there.
Otherwise, in the common language, what we can say is in common man language, only the keep. That's the term. I don't want to use it, but it is the understanding actually. The successor right will come to only people, those who are legally wedded.
But the illegitimate children will have. See, in a property rights, if a Hindu, I don't know whether this.
Now it is available for legitimate children.
If I don't know whether the query was on with regards to Hindu property, property of a Hindu or property of a Christian. Religion is also important here to know when it comes to succession. If it is assuming it was a question on the property. We don't know who the query was, whether if it was for Hindu law. See, in case of a death of a Hindu woman, the succession opens the class one heirs include the wife and children along with the mother of the deceased Hindu male. See, many times the mother of the Hindu male who died has been ignored. Either the daughter-in-law will never inform that the mother-in-law is alive, and that is why only daughter-in-law and the children take the property. But as per law, if the mother of the Hindu male who died intestate, even the mother gets a right. You see, in most of the court cases pertaining to LIC insurance policy, there are rival claims between the mother-in-law and the daughter-in-law, because even if you have made a nominee, if the wife is the nominee of the deceased husband, and the deceased husband's mother is alive, mother can stake a claim, because nominee is only an agent to receive the money. They don't have rights to enjoy the benefit as long as it is assignment to them or under a will. So when there is a rival claim, the nominee will not get it. Both the mother-in-law and the daughter-in-law will get equal rights into the assets and in all the properties, movable, immovable, left behind by the deceased male. That's the provision of law as on date also.
So can we move to next question, sir? I think elaborately it is the last question has been answered. So, sir, can I say the next question, sir? Himesh, sir, can I say the next question? Sir, am I audible?
Yes, Hitu ma'am, you are audible to me. Himesh, sir?
I think Himesh,
sir. Himesh, sir? I think so, he got disconnected. I'm not seeing
him. Yes, I also think so.
Hitu ma'am, can you make a call to him? However, Hari sir is there, so we can put the question.
So I can put a question. Yes.
Bolla sir is also there. Bolla sir is there. Hari sir is there. We can put the question. No problem.
Okay.
I come in now. I don't know what all has happened because I was in another human rights seminar or webinar on the human rights. So I was swapping between them and you in between. See,
sir,
in patents, I have one thing to say. When you go to court on patents, if you are challenged, you go to district court first. Okay, but if you challenge the validity of the patent, then the district court will transfer the case to the high court. Except that presidency towns of Madras, Chennai, Bombay, Calcutta, and these presidency towns, others don't have original jurisdiction. Other high courts don't have original jurisdiction. Only Bombay, Madras, Calcutta. High courts in these places have the original jurisdiction. And so in case of any validity question raised in a district court, the district court will transfer the case to the high court, to the respective high court.
So one question is there upon patent. I'm putting it. Assam, it is a question by P. Ganapati Murthy. Assam has an epitome of traditional knowledge, but how can we give it the status of patent?
If it is already on public domain, there's no question of patent, because most of these traditional knowledges are always on public domain. So state is the thing. Yesterday we have answered a similar question on this, if you remember, where we said village, pandit, village, panchayat, sarpanch may have to apply if it is a community traditional asset and things like that. It's like asking somebody to claim patent for Indian national song, national anthem.
Prashanjit, whether Himesh sir is connected now?
Sir, okay, admitting you, Dimesh sir is back. Sir, admitted you, sir. We'll make you host.
Yes, sir.
Sir?
Can you hear?
Okay. Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Okay, sir. Sir, I will put another question, sir. It is by... Sir, just a second. It is by Deepavali Brahma. Do you think in Patent Act, it is necessary for inventor to design or invent any product need to keep in consideration that 7 P's of marketing before designing?
Now, what is the last one?
Invent any product need to keep in consideration the 7 P's of marketing before designing.
It all depends actually. The marketing is an altogether a different phenomena. Because anything that will be useful to society only can be in a position to obtain a patent. Then automatically this issue is also addressed well within that requirement. Normally, you know, for example, now coming to the vaccine for the COVID-19 itself. It serves both the purpose, utility aspect as well as the societal use. And at the same time, the inventor should also spend his time, money, midnight oil they have burned. They should be benefited out of it. And also who can make the mass production also be looked into that particular aspect. That is where the patent law is very clear about all these things. In case if anybody invents a thing which is very much necessary for the society, and they are not in a position to give it an affordable cost, like what happened in this Bayer case, then you can obtain a compulsory license also. That is the provision of law. So normally, whoever creates, they will have that part also in their mind whenever they do so. Otherwise, subsequently also, they can enter into that domain. There is no bar actually. Yes.
Okay, sir. So next question is by Arijit Kundu. Is there any time period within which the application for patent has to be made after invention?
Yeah, see, now this is most important actually. That's why during course of our discussion, I told you about the provision in the patent law, something called as provisional patent and non-provisional patent application. That is, otherwise we call it as complete specification. Here, the time gap is between these two is 12 months. For example, if an inventor is through with almost 80 to 90% of his invention, like him, many will be working throughout the globe. The provision of law is only one person is able to obtain a patent. Then the provision of law is first come, first serve. That's why there is a provision being made under the law called as you can apply for a provisional patent. Then you have got 12 months time to complete the invention in the total extent, that is what is required under the law. Then you can apply for a non-provision application within that time. Then automatically you will enjoy the priority date. You'll be having the benefit also. That is very much required. But unless and until you make sure yourself that your invention is capable of obtaining a patent that is going to fulfill all the requirement of law, that is the patent law, don't make an attempt to do it actually, or don't go and publish anywhere else before making a provisional patent application. Because if you make a publication outside, then you come for applying for a patent, by that time your invention is already in the public domain. Are already in the public knowledge. So automatically you may lose your right to obtain a patent subsequently. That's why we advise all our inventors who are working like that, first apply for a provisional patent, then proceed to do whatever you want. In the meanwhile, once you apply for a provisional patent, the advantage is there for you also, because many investors are there looking in the area where the future in invention that may be successful in obtaining a patent. They may come to you for your financial assistance also. These are all the advantages of applying for a provisional patent, actually. Yes, I hope I am very clear with my explanation. Anything else required by the person who questioned it?
Sir, next question is by Ramesh Kumar Singh. So it is, how an advocate earned income by practicing patent law?
That is very comfortable.
That is very...
See, what I am doing, the same thing now. I am applying patent on behalf of the inventors.
That is.
That is very clear.
That is
but very... you should know what to do actually, what not to do. When you are thorough like any other professional, an advocate in the field of patent also can make good amount, both at the time of making an application for patent, so also during the pendency of the patent, where in case of an infringement is there also you can make money. Not making money, actually, you are serving your client and see that you are contributing to the cause of the society also. See, unlike in the IP field, in any other field, in the corporate field or in the litigation field, everywhere advocates are going to earn money, like doctors. So also advocates. Very scope is there for everyone. See, sky is the limit for you.
Yes.
I wish to just supplement a few thoughts that have been shared by a company in Bangalore City called IP Banana. Sir is knowing well aware of the executive of that particular company was sharing with us about the way how advocates also can help and prosper themselves so well. They are required to undergo a simple training, which the company is offering. Then they can do very well in the field, and it is desirable. And there is scarcity of hands as far as in this field, and the avenues are very well open, and you can visualize a luxurious life and very good earning in the IP field. Not only as a litigant, but as an assistant and assisting the corporate bodies which are in the legal field. That's what I wish to supplement.
No.
The prospects are very well.
Very much right, actually. Even today, we need such assistants who can take up IP as their career. If you are having that intuition and interest in that area to become an IP practitioner, you are most welcome. There's a great dearth, actually, in this field. All those who are practicing in IP field, I don't get the impression that they are very comfortable, actually. Only few are very comfortable, actually. But if you are thorough with the subject proper and the procedural aspect, definitely you can succeed in the field of IP. There's a great dearth. Today, in our office also, whenever such a person having that IP bent of mind, we accept the youngsters, actually. We will look into them when they come to us as an entrance only, when they are having a IP bent of mind. Then we will adopt them into our system, actually, if they are interested. That is very clear. See, every field there is scope. Corporate field there is scope. Property matters there is scope. Litigation there is scope. Dearth is there in every field because sky is so high. And the need for a very good advocate or a practitioner is a end of the day. There may be hundreds of law institutions, but do we catering to the need of the society? It's a big question for us, actually. Because as an academician, I know the limitation. As a practitioner also, I know the limitation. There's a great dearth of a person who is really willing to grow in that field. Because most of the youngsters, what I'm watching is, they want instant gain. The year they come, in a couple of years, they want to be in an established way, a special office, a bungalow, couple of assistants to move around with that, a wonderful four-wheeler, No, I am not against to that. You are going to have it actually. My own student have seen, they are my partners in my organization. They have become judges, they are practitioners. They are earning not less than 5-figure, 6-figure income every month, I am telling you. It is possible in the IP field also.
Yes, indeed.
Yes.
Sir, can we move to the next question?
Sure, sure.
Okay, another question is by Gautam Barua. Some leading case law on patent law for clear conception. The case law, he's asking for case law on patent law. Some leading case law.
Which construction?
So upon patent law. Some leading case laws on patent law. For a clear conception. So he's asking some leading case law on patent law.
Which construction? Civil construction.
No, sir. For clear conception. So for clearing his concept, he wants some case laws.
Plenty of case laws are there. Plenty of case laws are there. Which field do you want actually? Of ITBT, you want in the field of technology, or you want in the field of mobile phones only. If you look into the dispute between Apple and Samsung, there are more than 50 cases as far as Apple and Samsung, where Apple has won against Samsung in many jurisdictions, and Samsung has won in a couple of jurisdictions against Apple. Navratis case, there is plenty of cases are there. If you go to Google itself and search latest cases on patents, you will get a list of patents, either in India or abroad, anywhere. Globally, you will get a good number of case laws.
The next question is by Supriti Hazarika. Does an improvement in a patented technology calls for a new patent, or the existing patent suffices?
That's what I told you in my presentation. There is a scope for patent addition. If there is an improvement in that, you can add to that so that the benefit will be there for you only. But in a patent addition application, the benefit will be there for the duration against which the original patent will be there. For example, your original patent is going to be extended till 2025. Now you are going to have an addition, patent addition to that with the original patent. So the second application, if it is considered as an addition, then the benefit will be there for you to enjoy the right till 2025, not beyond that. Is it clear?
Sir, I'm audible now, sir?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so there is another question. I think this is second question by Dr. Chokyo Taku. Already he has you have answered one question. So the question is, on state of Meghalaya, women are the head family as master key, which property inheritance is owned by their daughter child and not for son child. Then how can be son or male deprived of property inheritance?
This has nothing to do with the IP law, but still for the curiosity of that particular gentleman.
It is similar to that of Maramagatta in Kerala. You have that kind of systems and customary laws, they prevail over the general law. See, and it's for the policy makers to think of and do good to the situation.
See, in Kerala, there is Aliya Santanam. Aliya means the son-in-law. Yeah. The daughters are more powerful in Kerala than the sons. That is the tradition there, the custom there. Because you all in the northeast part, maybe you are all from the school of Dayabaga. You are all from the Mitakshara family actually when it comes to Hindu law. And that is by Agnayan Mitakshara by Vignaneshwara. So it's all the practices, the customary practices. When it comes to personal law, it is up to the state to decide that what best can be given actually.
Even in...
Yes, sir.
Mr. Bibesh, sir, okay, to add to what you said, Aliya Santana law is more prevalent even in Karnataka, in Mangalore area.
Mangalore.
Yeah, South Canara, Mangalore area. Yeah. Aliya Santana, where the matriarchal system,
yes,
to, of hierarchy for property assets succession is through that particular the women folk there. So that is a tradition in the Mangalore belt also.
Whatever the tradition, Harish sir, I will tell you one thing. Who is the boss in your home?
Sir, home minister is the boss, sir. I have a saying to say, when you are a bachelor, you are your own boss, sir. Once you get married, once the female boss enters the house, she is the boss. We are only finance minister, sir. We should not even question after you.
It happened,
order, social order in the house.
Yeah, it happened in one of my friend's wedding, actually. There was a big placard placed outside that Shankar weds Asha, or Asha weds Shankar, like that. Then his father-in-law was telling me, today Asha weds Shankar. From tomorrow onwards, Asha leads Shankar.
Yes.
Exactly.
That should be.
Exactly.
It's a lovely comment, and it's desirable that in every household we have.
You're your own boss till the female boss enters your life.
Yes.
So we male members are always parasites, sir.
Definitely, sir.
Actually.
And women are the best multitaskers, sir. We cannot match them. We have to go and.
That women they enjoy, that's what I have seen in my own
experience. No empiricism is required in this regard. Consensus opinion, and women are the best rulers in the family.
I think, Shilpi, I think we have answered the question of that particular participant. So it again depends upon the customary practice prevailing at that area. According to that only, the rights will be there, actually.
Like West Bengal also, Mithakshara School of Law. In West Bengal, it's Mithakshara School of Law. Dayabhaga School of Law. Dayabhaga School of Law, sorry.
Dayabhaga School of Law.
Yeah.
Any questions?
I'll take leave, sir. I need to attend
I would have loved that you would have stayed with me from the beginning, actually.
Sir, I had another human rights conscious seminar in my alma mater, so I had to be there. So I was swapping between two systems. I used to get up there, go there in another system.
You want the right feedback from persons like you, actually.
I really had to deny myself the opportunity of being with you from the beginning because of that alma mater webinar where the vice chancellor of Ishwar Bhatt was there, the vice chancellor of Bangalore University, Kutino.
He was my teacher.
He was also my teacher also, so that is why.
Yeah.
So I kindly accept my apologies. I should not miss you. Even in the end, at least I should join you. That's right.
That was the very first day I watched you, actually. I was also there in the webinar.
Oh, I see.
That was interesting. Your interpretation was very powerful.
I would love to. We'll get together, sir. I am also here, so we can get together once.
Sure, sir. I love to associate with you.
Yeah, definitely, sir. I would have loved to be there today, but I was telling Shilpi yesterday, I'll somehow try to make it. I have too many things to swap between. I have a pious ceremony at my relatives' house, so I need to leave. That's right.
Compared to other intellectual property rights, patent is the one of the most interesting and the toughest one.
Definitely. Patent's life is short-lived, so you have to take it as soon as you get. Otherwise, it's no point going in. That is why.
The opportunistic also.
Yeah.
That is why. And once it's on public domain, then everybody gets it.
Thank you very much, sir.
Oh, pleasure, sir. I will catch up with you sometime. I just need to go to Vidyaranyapura, a long way to go. So I need to attend some pious ceremony there. That is why.
Sure.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
I'll take leave of all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I think the question and answer session is also over. There are no more questions unless Prasenjit adds something.
So actually a question from Deepavali Brahma. Suppose inventor did not assign or nominated any nominee, and due to some circumstances the inventor died or met with an accident, is the design product will be automatically dissolved?
No. If the person is having any legal successors, automatically the right will be there for the successors. Like any other property rights, this also will be there. The successory rights. Who comes in law as a successor, that person will enjoy, that he or she, maybe a daughter, son, or whoever may be the person, they will going to enjoy the right actually, if a deceased person is there.
So that means it will be dependent on the person to person, religion to religion, and Dayavarga and Mitaksha.
Hello, in case if you are not married, then wife and children will not be there. Then your paternal people, those who are all there, maybe parents or your brother or sister, whoever may be there, they are going to succeed your right actually. Depends upon the successory right according to the Hindu law or Mohammedan law or Christian law, like that.
So actually, if the participant is a non-law person, then you need to know the class one here and class two here concept actually.
Yeah.
Yes. So another question from Bhautina. Is that how are the claims in patenting? How can I know about originality of my idea, oblique product, before filing for patenting?
Yeah. See, there's a mechanism, I tell you, there is a search mechanism is there. That's why we ask you to do the prior art search. There are two types of engines are there. One is the paid search mechanism. Another is the open mechanism like Google and all. You can do the search actually. Make yourself comfortable that no such person has claimed the similar type of thing that what you are claiming actually. Otherwise, you take the assistance of any attorney or any person who is practicing a patent agent. They will do the search on your behalf. They will give the search report to you. There they are going to mention that what are the advantages and limitations of your invention, whether to proceed to file for a patent or not. That you have to do actually. It is very clear.
Okay, sir. Sir, shall we move to the next question?
Sure.
Okay. This question is from Shruti Basumatari. Are there any alternatives to applying for a patent?
Alternative means you want to protect your invention, means you have to patent it. Otherwise, keep it as a trade secret. Like what Coca-Cola, they're having the recipe, till now they have not obtained a patent because patent will be last for 20 years. Beyond that, it will come to public domain. The Coca-Cola recipe, the formula, they have not disclosed it to any person. Only 2% they know it. Those 2%, they never move together actually. Because as long you can keep things confidential, you can keep it as secret, you can maintain it. Otherwise, you have to obtain a patent, because if you want to play in a public domain, you have to protect it actually. It is as simple as that. When you are wearing all the jewelry on your body, if you move in an open road where more traffic and people are there, how you are going to protect it? That is very simple. So now, like Bangalore or Mysore or any place, the child snatching is a very common phenomenon. It's also a property. If you expose yourself to the public, then you need protection. You have to protect your guard yourself. Same way, the inventions also. If your invention is secretly used without disclosing to the public, then you can use it as long as you can protect it. Otherwise, get it patented. That's all.
Thank you, sir. I hope the answer has been given to the participant. And we are with no more question left out, because all the questions have been answered, I think so. Okay, there is another question. Sir, in the
instance of Coca-Cola, somebody asked the instance in Coca-Cola. What is that?
Yes, sir.
The same thing, no? I gave the example.
Yes, sir, same thing. So, participants, if any one of you are willing to directly communicate with our resource person, sir, then definitely you can raise your hand so that we can unmute you and you can directly talk with him. You can interact, you can share your ideas, and you can even put queries directly to him. If anyone of you want, please.
Yes, I think most of their queries being addressed by me. If still any questions are there, I have given my email ID to you in my screen.
Yes, sir.
And you can obtain it from Preeta. And you can write to me. I love to answer all your queries. If anything is not there, I thank the organizers. Dr. Mohan Balla sir, and Harish has already left. Prasen, then Pilpi, yes, Brita, then Borua, and all the learned participants. I believe the webinar is very interesting to you. I have given a few of the technical aspects as well as the legal aspect to you, so that you can digest both the things. I know it's a very lengthy proposition to understand the issue concerning patent. We address all these things in two semesters, actually, in one or two semesters in our law course in post-graduation, because it's a very vast area. How much you dig it up, that much you are going to get that much of information as far as patent is concerned. I hope in the coming days we will meet again and have more interaction. I thank Preeta for inviting me for this webinar. I thank everybody who made it possible. A big thanks from me, actually. I love to associate with both the institutions in future also. Mohan sir, if you want, I will come to your institution also.
Very kind of you, sir. Very kind of you for that offer and fabulous zipped up presentation on the patents. We could enjoy it well, and it's a very great knowledgeable exercise with the interface by several technical and quite interesting phenomena added favor, flavor, and what is that? The robotizing presentation. No. Very great.
Because I have addressed in KLE for this AI itself, couple of sessions.
Yes, sir.
Because now the inventions are made by the AIs, actually.
Yeah, that's correct.
Who is going to own the patent? That's a big question. Many cases are being landed up in US, actually.
That's correct. And actually, I have been waiting for my students to come up to learn intellectual property, Lass, to invite you. Therefore, there's a long gap.
For everybody, sir, not necessarily the students, actually.
Yeah, that's correct.
Now I am associated with many technical institutions, actually. Mm-hmm. Almost minimum 2 to 3 programs I'll be giving for these engineering colleges, both for teachers as well as students, because they need it, actually. They are the one who create it. They don't know how to protect it, actually. They don't know how to explain it, actually. And the limitations were there. What is there to listen from a law teacher and lawyer? Now the perception has been changed. Actually, they know what are the importance of intellectual property, how best they can protect it, actually. Good. People are getting that awareness. We are there to create that awareness with them.
Yes, sir.
Don't associate any such programs, sir.
Good.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. Yeah.
Offer you formal vote of thanks.
Sure. I love to have it.
Sir, thank you, Bhimesh sir, and Mohan Bolla sir for joining in the session. Bhimesh sir, thank you for accepting our invitation as an invited speaker.
Mm.
Otherwise, our workshop would have been incomplete without you, sir.
You could have charged me. You got every right, actually.
Yes. And happy to have you. And as we all know that in Assam, the IPR is still blooming. Yes, so your session and this workshop is definitely going to help all of us. And it will definitely enhance our existing knowledge. We thank you enough, sir. And it is so good to see you after 6 years.
Yeah.
After six long years.
That's what now I'm very happy that you remembered me, Mohan, and all. I love you very much because you are all, your team was a very lovable team for me at that time. Yourself, Rak, that Saket, Gokul, and all in your team.
I asked Gokul to join, but he has some engagement in the court, it seems. Mm-hmm. He couldn't join. Otherwise, I sent him the link.
And the most important thing with me is most of my students are either they are on my LinkedIn or my Facebook, actually.
Mm-hmm.
But very frequently, I'll be meeting them, actually. Very frequently. Starting
so
from
we hope to see you soon, sir.
I'm there in Christ from the very first batch of LLM, actually.
Yes, yes.
The first batch, only 5 students were there, actually, the first batch.
Yes, sir.
No, IP.
Just then only I joined Christ.
Huh?
Just then only, yes, that sir? Batch only I joined Christ. That was 2 years LLM, right?
Yeah, 2 years LLM. Then there's now almost 25 to 30 candidates will be there for IP.
Yes.
Every year.
Back in then, we didn't have IP specialization. We had a subject in the corporate and commercial law, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's also
IPR as a whole. Good.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. We appreciate your presence and thank you for enlightening us more about patents. And thank you, participants. And you made this workshop lively with all your queries because the queries helps each of us to clarify more. So your queries made this session more interactive and more lively. So we hope for similar cooperation for the next 2 days. We'll have Srinivasulu sir tomorrow, and then in the end we'll have Ramakrishna sir, the professor of law from NLSIU Bangalore. So thank you, sir. Thank you, Mohan Rao, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I anticipate only that this COVID will over and we can go to Kokrajhar and have tea in our friend Preeta's chamber, actually.
We'll attend our Preeta's marriage, sir.
Nice.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good. Enjoy.